Have you been thinking on how you can convert the water on your off-grid property into something that you can actually drink, but you're not really sure where to begin? Well, in this video, I'm going to be showing you a budget-friendly system that might help you to turn your rainwater or any other source of water into something that you can actually drink. Now, let's dive into some of the nuances and show you what I've learned so far with the various different methods that I've been experimenting with on how you can convert your water on your off-grid property into something that you can actually drink. And as a full disclaimer, I should probably mention right off the bat that, you know, a lot of this is going to be trial and error. I'm not a professional. I am just some guy on the internet that really likes to share my journey and my experiences with doing a lot of stuff off-grid. You will need to try some things out for yourself. Everybody's internal water filtration system, if you will be slightly different. Some people can tolerate more contaminants than others. Some people don't mind drinking mountain water straight from a river. Some people are sensitive to this. So, you know, there's a lot of factors to consider with creating drinkable water. Hopefully, even for the long term, with the various different methods that I'm going to be showing you in this video, hopefully one of these methods might work out for you. And I might make a part two to this whole system to share with you how it evolves over time after many months or even up to a year or more experimenting with the system. I've been using it so far for the last couple of weeks, and I've been testing out a lot of trial and error, different formulas, if you will. And so far I've gotten something which I'm happy with. And I really like the idea of like harvesting water from the roof that you collect yourself in a tank, and then you process this water and you can use it for brushing your teeth, showering, doing the dishes, and even cooking, and also something that you can actually drink. But there are a lot of things to factor in. Even if you live near the city, for example, and you're collecting rainwater, you've got to consider, is the air where you're collecting your rainwater from, is that already contaminated? Now, personally, I live in between the mountains and the city. My area has a fairly decent air quality to do rain harvesting. And also on the property, we do not have access to river water or water from a well. If you do, obviously that will increase the quality of the water that you start off with. And the water that you start off with will improve this filtration system that I'm about to show you. If you can get the cleanest water that you can get right off the beginning, there will be less steps involved when it comes to actually creating drinkable water. I will also share with you some of the pros and cons and some of the alternatives that you could do to creating drinkable water on a budget. This could also be a system for emergencies in an off-grid setting. So the first thing that we want to start off with is, where is the water coming from? So my water is basically falling off my roof, going into a large 500 liter tank. Filter out as much debris as possible that arrives onto your roof. Now, I live in a heavily forested area, and when it comes to filtering that debris that comes from your roof and might go through your gutter system, try to maybe put like cloth or a nylon sock or stocking or anything that can try to reduce the amount of debris that you get from leaves or, for example, pollen or dust. Try and reduce the amount of sediment that's going to build up in your water catchment system. You also want to get a black tank that stops a lot of algae growing inside the tank. That's one thing to consider. It'll be a lot of trial and error, so everybody's going to have to experiment with what works for them. Get the cleanest water that you can to start off with. With rainwater, if you're not using any bore water or well or river water, is that your water will not be mineralized. So that's one thing to consider. And on top of that, the pH will be quite low, so the acidity will be quite high. But I'll show you some neat little tricks that don't cost a lot of money to try and improve that. Another thing I like to do with the rainwater in the tank is I will sometimes put one or two tablets of chlorine. A lot of people are not a big fan of chlorine. I kind of get why, but if you use it in very small quantities, it's actually not that bad. Try and get the purest, simplest chlorine that you can get with the least amount of stuff added in. You don't want to use the chlorine that you use for cleaning toilets, for example. This is not suitable for putting in your water if you want to drink it. Again, you don't need to do this step if you don't want to. You could use a UV filter. Then what I do is I take this water and I put it into the water distiller. Now, this water distiller, you can find this on AliExpress. I've got a link down below. The model I've got is a really basic model. It doesn't have a timer on it or anything like that. And what this does is it basically just distills water. That's all it does. It's a very simple model. I think it costs like $50. Whenever you put distilled water into a kettle, you will not get any calcium buildup in the kettle. That's one thing. If you can, try and get the water distiller that has the timer on it. I went for the most basic model. Now, this one is designed actually for filtering tap water. Personally, I've been experimenting with putting rainwater in it, and actually I've been getting some really interesting results. So this water distiller, if we just go through the basic rundown of how it works, the first part on the top has a coil of a pipe that runs through with a heat sink, and it's got a fan. It'll go through the pipe with the fan around it, and that's where the water vapor will escape through. So it will go through this pipe. Basically, water distillation, you need to boil water, create vapor, and then have it in a sealed chamber that it travels through the one escape route and drips through on the other end. And you need the pipe to be cooler than the water so that it condenses inside the pipe. Now, on the little spout on the end, you can also replace these little small carbon filters that help to improve the taste of the distilled water. Because for a lot of people, distilled water does have a strange taste to it, which you might want to experiment with. Some people don't mind this. Personally, I don't have a for or against approach with distilled water. I just want it to obviously purify my water. That's all I care about with trying to do this method. It's a very easy way to wipe out all viruses and bacteria and any nasty things. Any heavy compounds will be basically left as debris inside the tank. You're basically separating the water from dirt or bacteria, viruses, you name it. This is a very simple but effective approach to creating pure H2O. It's going to be quite acidic, so you need to kind of mitigate that. And again, we're working with rainwater, which is already quite acidic. Yeah, I think it's got like a 5 or 6 on the acidic scale when I measured it with the very basic water testing kit. I recommend trying to get a kit which measures all sorts of different things. That way you can check your water quality. When the tank is completely all vaporized and all of the water has disappeared out of the tank and transferred into the container, which it comes with, which is just a standard plastic one. You might want to use a glass one instead if you want. It actually switches itself off automatically, so that's good. However, I would recommend that there's a very small layer of water left in the tank. This basically means that the tank doesn't try to vaporize all of the contaminants that are left over in the bottom, and it'll improve the taste of water substantially. You can put only 2 liters of water in if you want, but again, you'll have to get a bit creative on using the timer. And that's why I recommend going for the timer model instead of using the standard one without the timer. It runs on 700 watts. You will need to have a pretty substantial solar system to run one of these if you're running off grid. If you're connected to the grid, you won't need to worry about this at all. But this one basically can filter 4 liters in roughly 4 hours. Now, personally, I have a giant solar panel array of 800 watts. On a sunny day, I can run this for about the 4 hour period where I'm getting peak performance. Now, once I've got this pure water, one thing I noticed is that the carbon filter that comes with it did improve the taste of the water. I definitely recommend using these little carbon filters that come with it. However, I would say that with the water I've been putting in, I was still getting some VOCs, some volatile organic compounds. I would say there was some kind of taste of that still getting through the system. And that's just because some vapors will basically transfer themselves through the vapor. Again, if you're using tap water, you do not need to worry about this at all. If you're using river water, you won't need to worry about this. I can't really describe the taste with words, but essentially there was something. Now, as you can see, the water was very clean. It was very clear. It's pure water. You can just start drinking this and it's actually quite good for an emergency. However, I would say to improve the taste further, I personally opted to put it through a gravity filter system. You can get, there's all sorts of different branded gravity filters. I will leave a link to one I found on a budget on AliExpress. You can have a look at that one. The one I've got is from Purewell, and the filters inside are some secondhand carbon filters. You don't also have to buy a brand new tank. You could make this DIY. You don't have to do like the whole buy a kit. You know, you could make this DIY. It might also be improvement to also use a ceramic filter if you want. You could experiment with that. And I basically take this distilled water, I put it through the gravity filter system. So it's kind of going through two systems, which definitely improves the taste and also it removes any extra contaminants that could possibly be getting through the water distillation. So it's kind of like a double system in this way. Also, this helps try to remove any chlorine that might have been getting through the water distillation process. One thing I would definitely recommend, lightly mineralize the water and try to get more of an alkaline water. So one of the ways I do that is that you just take some baking soda. It's really cheap, doesn't cost a lot of money. You just take a pinch of baking soda. It's really not a lot. You need a very small amount and you put it in the 3 or 4 liters that you've made. And then that will increase the alkaline level. You can also get pH tester kits or digital pH measurers. And you want to sit around anything above 7 or around 8, you just want to raise that level a little bit higher. 6 and 5 is a bit low on the pH scale. That's a bit too acidic. So you want to try and make it a little bit more alkaline. And another benefit to using the baking soda is that it actually lightly mineralizes the water at the same time. Now, obviously, it's not giving you all the minerals that you would normally get from, say, a river or tap water, but it does improve the mineralization. I've also tried putting river water and lake water through the water distiller, and it also creates very pure water on the other end after you've distilled it. So this water distiller is actually really effective at removing any solid contaminants that were in the water previously. You could almost just take dirty water from a puddle and you could put it in the water distiller if you wanted to, and it'll basically filter out a lot of that contaminant because the contaminants will be left behind in the tank. However, when you do that, you'll have a lot of gunk to clean up in the tank. So you always want the water that you start off with to be as clean as possible before you start trying to distill it. If any of you out there that have more experience with filtering your water on a budget, on an off-grid setting, and you want to share your thoughts down in the comments, you can share down in the comments below. I'm definitely open to hear some suggestions. Something I have researched is that you can get Myphon stones or shungite. These stones, basically, or even ceramic beads, you can basically put these in the tank, and this will lightly help mineralize the water without adding any mineral drops. This is something I'd like to test myself. I'm still waiting for those to arrive in the mail, but this, in theory, would allow you to add a little bit more mineralization to the water. And I found that adding baking soda definitely helps make the water taste a bit more smooth and soft. And you really don't want to add too much. This is going to be a lot of trial and error for people. But if you're willing to put in the time, you can cut down on your water bill a lot because you can just harvest the water that you're getting that lands on your roof or the water that you might have on your property. You can basically filter this. You might be able to just distill the water and that might be enough with the small carbon filter. Or you might be able to use a gravity filter system like the one I've shown you, and that might be enough. I have also researched about reverse osmosis and stuff like this. However, reverse osmosis does use quite a lot of water in order to filter itself. It is an effective way as well to filter your water. You might want to research about those systems as well. If you're conserving every drop like rainwater, you might not want to go for a reverse osmosis system. I can't stress this point enough, is that everybody's bodies might react differently to different water sources and where you are in your local area. Take these as just ideas as what you could have an experiment with and see what works for you. Personally, I can go off to the mountains and I can drink raw, unfiltered river water and even lake water, and I've been fine. I've never had issues with that, with the water I've been drinking up in the mountains. However, when you're talking about the water that flowed down a river with a farm that's using pesticides on their land, this is when I would definitely avoid trying to use just that type of river water. And I have tried drinking water which is straight from a nearby city, and I did actually get ill from that once. So you're going to have to get a bit creative and do a lot of trial and error with this. But for me, this has been a really interesting experiment to find out how I can create drinkable water with the water that falls just off my roof, which is amazing. Definitely stay subscribed for future updates on this system and how the system progresses over time. I have some other videos that talk about getting off grid for beginners, so you might want to have a look at that video. But that's it for now. Like and subscribe, and I hope to see you in a future video.